Travis Kelce has touchdown in Australia.
Come on, are you sure?
He has Taylor Swift's lover boy arriving at Sydney Airport just moments ago.
Let's go out to our own lover boy, Jackie Hahn, who's on the case. Jack, was someone on the plane?
Well, look, I want to tell you that right now he's just about to touch down. Oh. So he's at a flight level of 1,200 feet right now. I'm tracking it on my phone. He's coming in over Kurnell in Sydney's south, lining up for our main runway here, runway 34 left, a very long runway. So he's going to come all the way in, probably take that whole runway up and then turn. It's a right turn for him. He'll come in here to the private jet base where he'll be met by his private security and the border force. Yes. I know too much about aviation. Please forgive me.
No, I love it. I love it.
Tell you what, it's going to be a superstar arrival for him. We've got a full scores of media here. We've also got radio and a few fans as well, and a lot of security as well. Taylor Swift's security detail is here. You can see them all there. They look like they're on the blacklist or Chicago PD. They've got their earpieces on there. Secret business. So yeah, we're expecting his jet to touch down any moment now. I'll quickly check the flight radar for you again, and he's just about to come in that final moment landing Jack. Right now. So you can see that on your aeroplane. Just looking here, flight level 500 feet, slowing down. He'll touch down any second now. Yes, Carl?
Jack, we've got live shots of the plane, so don't need to go to the flight tracker. And he is about to touch down in like any second. When you mentioned the security detail there, have they been giving you any indication on who's on board the flight exactly? Have you been able to sniff out a yarn?
Well, I had better luck talking to the brick wall, to be honest. These are some very professional security guards that have no time for the media. But look, I'll tell you what, they're Taylor Swift security guards, so, you know, 2 and 2 equals 4. And it's probably Travis Kelce on his aeroplane. It's been reported in the US. We're hearing it here. Soon we'll see it with our own eyes and confirm it. But, guys, just very quickly.
Hang on, in three, in two, in one.
Touchdown! Kelce's in Australia, we think, along with an entourage and whoever else is on the plane. Of course, this may or may not be true, but it has not stopped us from soaking up hours and hours of live airtime today.
And annoying a lot of viewers in the process.
It's been all about that. Mm. Listen, we're going to let that plane track. You stand by, Jack Hahn, for the mayhem that will ensue when he exits the plane or whoever else is on that plane.
The level of fandom is really on its own level. Dickie, have you seen, you know, we were discussing this on the Today Show a moment ago, you've seen a lot of big celebs come to town in your time.
Well, the One Direction thing, oh, here we go, what's this happening?
That's the man
in the suit.
That's the man in the suit. Okay. Yeah. Thanks for pointing that out. Yeah, Trev's probably not going to be wearing a tie. Yeah, look, the One Direction thing was pretty massive. I remember going to San Diego in South America to do an interview with the boys to announce an Australian tour, and the level of fandom there, I mean, there were 20,000 kids, they reckon, around the hotel that night just screaming. No one got any sleep in the hotel. But that was pretty huge, the One Direction thing, but nothing like this. This is just a global phenomenon. And everywhere she goes, she sells out shows and creates this sort of attention. I mean, this is not a unique thing. Wherever she goes, she attracts. And now Travis, it's just exponential now. He's involved,
and now
isn't it?
She's got the NFL fans on board as well. So her reach is just kind of growing, isn't it? Expanding every day. This could take all day.
It could.
It could be here all day. I'm enjoying it.
Well,
but,
I guess the big question is, where will they go tonight? She's clearly making the most of her time in Sydney and experiencing all that the Harbour City has to offer. Now that she's got, you know, Bay in town, are they going to go out and have a romantic dinner?
Well, they're in Barangaroo, so maybe they'll stick around there.
Some of the best restaurants in Australia are at Crown and Sydney, so you don't have to.
Here we go.
Movement.
What's going on here? This. Come on, cameraman, go in there, please. Is that Trav?
Looks like it could be him.
Oh, that could be Travis.
Oh, no, that looks like it could be Travis.
I think that's Travis.
He's brought his brother.
Is that his brother in tow?
Possibly.
He's brought a mate.
That looks like Travis, the second one.
He's got the sporty attire on, so, you know.
Definitely not an IT crowd, so I'm feeling even more confident now that this is Travis Kelce.
Very, very excited.
His backwards cap and his sporting athleisure gear, I would say we are onto the right person here.
And as Carl was saying this morning, it's quite quick, isn't it, when you're on a private jet? Mm. You're just sort of taken away, whisked away. You don't have to wait in any lines. It's
some
quite
degree
easy.
Of knowledge.
Well, not me personally.
No, it's Carl This is not a Jetstar experience, no. With all respect to our friends at Jetstar.
So only two people have climbed out. It looks like it's Travis and his brother, we think. We're obviously not certain because we're looking at this from quite a distance. we'll firm up those details for you shortly. But it appears as though, as Dickie said, Travis Kelce has made yet another touchdown in Sydney this morning.
It could be his bro, because we know they pre-recorded their podcast that they do together.
And so they do it. They're thick as thieves, aren't they? They go everywhere together.
Go. Yeah, that would be a lot of fun. But then also he'd be third wheeling as well with Taylor.
I don't mind that.
It's a bit awkward.
Looks like a good
time.
Figure
something out. Don't worry about that.
They'll have fun.
But it's a long trip. You might as well take your brother along.
I think so.
Play some cards. Yeah. I would have thought so.
Well, he needs company while she's on stage as well. It's a 3-hour show. You don't want to stand there on your own.
Hey, bro, what are you doing? Want to go to Australia to see the girlfriend?
Why would you say no to that?
Go along for the ride.
All right. Well, we will. You can be sure we'll be tracking that car to see where they go next and what is in store for Taylor and Travis. Well, they're both here in Sydney.
Well done.
Straight to Sydney Airport, where Taylor Swift's boyfriend, Travis Kelce, has just touched down. Let's go live to Jack Hahn, who's in the thick of it and has been waiting all morning. Jack, have you spotted your man yet?
Yeah, we certainly have. We do have a little bit of breaking news for you right now to bring you to Ven. If we just go straight to these live chopper pics into our studio, you can see that Travis is still on the tarmac, on the taxiways in that van. It appears that he is going to the international terminal. He's gliding past the domestic terminal. You can see some Jetstar aircraft, some Virgin aircraft, heading to the other side of the airport, in fact, to go to the international terminal. Why is that? Well, it very well could be that he needs to get his passport stamped there, perhaps his cars are waiting. So we'll figure that out, but he's certainly not coming out of the exits here at the private jet base. I can tell you a lot of people are here to say good day to him. We've got some fans here. Hello, hello. What brought you out here? I love the In My Chiefs era. Going to say good day to Travis?
That's the plan. I'm here to see Travis, not Taylor.
What about you? Do you think Tay-Tay might, pop here as well, or she's waiting back at the apartment?
Amazing, but if I was her, I would stay in the hotel.
Yeah, hopefully. She comes.
Are you guys in town for the Eras tour or what?
Yeah.
Of course. Like, I'm here on Friday.
Yeah. Are you worried about the rain? Are you a little bit concerned?
Yeah, a little.
We brought ponchos.
Yeah.
Good move. All right, guys. Well, hopefully you see you, Travis. We're still tracking him on our Nine News helicopter. So, again, we're seeing his vehicle going on the taxiway at Sydney Airport. Usually you can get your passport stamped on board the private jet and then glide right out of the gate. So it would suggest that if he's heading to the international terminal that he's going to have to say g'day to our Border Force officials over there instead, Davina.
I hope they're not Taylor Swift fans, otherwise maybe get held up for a bit. Jack, thank you so much. Mass speculation, Dickie and Sylvia, over who he's travelling with. This guy that looks exactly like him could be his brother. I reckon it's his decoy.
Well, I don't know. I think, so this could be, I have a super fan sending me intel on the text message right now, and she believes that's Travis coming first, and the person behind may be a friend by the name of Ross Travis.
So not brother
Jason, which will break the hearts of many who are obsessed with Jason Kelce, because he is, well, he's a whole lot of
he's
fun,
going
isn't
all right
he?
Too, yeah.
But anyway, look, we're all speculating.
I love that
the
you've
moment.
Got like top secret sources.
It's journalism, Davina.
I know.
That's journalism.
And we have the best in the business right here today for you.
We do.
Well, the Nine Network newsroom is.
They let out a cheer
right
when that jet touched down. Yeah, can you believe so?
I know.
I'll have some actual news for you coming up in half an hour.
I don't know. This is all anyone's talking about. We love your work, Davina. Thank you.
Thank you. Well,